He went to Rasulullah said, Ya Rasulullah, this is what happened, and these people, they want some food, and they're upset about it. Can you give me some food? He said, yeah, go see Usama bin Zayd. He's in charge of these things for the Prophet ﷺ, the food and all these things. He said, go see him. If he has any food, tell him to give it to you. He went to Usama radiallahu anhu, said, Ya Usama, he said, well, I don't have any food. There's no food in the house of the Prophet ﷺ. Huh? The house of the Prophet ﷺ. Let's look at our houses. And that's so we can remember the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no food. Usama tells him, Ya Salman, there is no food in the house of the Prophet ﷺ. Salman now is in trouble, but he's going to tell these people. He went to the people and he said, I'm sorry, there's no food in the house. He said, then go other Sahaba and ask them for food. You're in charge, we made you in charge. So he went. And Sahaba, they said, I'm sorry, we don't have anything. So look at the life of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. Goes back to the two people, says, they don't have any food. One of them tells the other, Wallahi, if we send Salman to a well of water, he will dry it up. He'll be dry. And then, what did they do? Then they took Salman and they said, we're going to go and look. He said, no, I'm not going to go. You're going to go look. They told him, we don't believe Usama. He told you that he didn't have any food, but he did. He's just stingy. Bakhil. So they went and started what? Looking at Usama from far, see if there's anything they can see, any food. And the Prophet ﷺ, of course, Jibreel comes to him and tells him, this is what happened. And he goes right away and he stands in front of these two people. And he looks at them, he said, how come I see some meat in your mouth? He said, Ya Rasulullah, what do you mean meat? We haven't eaten meat today all day. He said, you haven't eaten meat all day, but you have talked about Usama and Salman. That's why I see meat in your mouth. وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا. It's like you're eating, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, it's like you're eating the flesh of your fellow brother, dead flesh. فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ. You don't like it, why would you do that? Many of these things, dear brothers, these misjudgments and lying, look what it leads to. Destruction in society. And it leads to what? Evaporation of the love and understanding and cooperation among people. أقول لكم هذا وصف. الحمد لله كما ينبغي لجلاله وكماله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله. أما بعد. In few weeks ago, before I went to England, I had said here that we kind of fall short talking about the Khulafa al-Rashidin radiallahu anhu. We don't talk about them much. We don't know about them much, really. And specifically, we don't even talk about Sayyidina Uthman and Sayyidina Ali among the Khulafa al-Rashidin. Some people whose hearts are some kind of shaky or diseased, or they have bad judgment about people, they thought that this is meant to be that we favor one over the other. So let me say this very clearly. Because there is no need to misjudge each other. And there is no need to lie on behalf of each other. I have taught Al-Tahawiyya for the past 12 or 13 years, and I have written that book about 12 years ago. You can all go back to it, page 155. Imam Al-Tahawiyya, rahimahullah, said, which I say, believe and practice, وَنُثْبِتُ الْخِلَافَةَ لِأَبِي بَكْرٍ الصَّدِّيقِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أَوَّلًا تَقْدِيمًا لَهُ وَتَفْضِيلًا عَلَى جَمِيعِ الْأُمَّةِ ثُمَّ لِعُمَرَ بْنَ الْخَطَّابِ ثُمَّ لِعُثْمَانُ بْنُ عَفَّانِ ثُمَّ لِعَلِيِّ بْنِ أَبِي طَالِبِ. Which means, the direct translation, that we confirm that the Khilafah went first to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, proving and confirming his superiority and his advancement over the entire Ummah. And then the Khilafah came to Umar al-Khattab, then to Uthman ibn Affan, then to Ali ibn Abi Talib. Those people need to clean their hearts and not suspect Muslims. When we talk about these things, dear brothers and sisters, because we have that sensitivity syndrome. The sensitivity syndrome is what? Is anybody who talks about anything, we want to classify him right away.
What are you? Are you Wahhabi or you're Sufi or you're this or you're this or you're Tahriri or what are you?
We want to immediately put some labels on them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want us to do these things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to clear your heart and don't think bad about your fellow brothers. When I said that, I meant it is true. It is a fact. We have so much to learn from Sayyidina Uthman. Sayyidina Uthman was the one who ruled most of the four khulafa. 12 years. 12 years he ruled. More than Abu Bakr, more than Umar, more than Uthman, more than Ali. Sayyidina Uthman. How many times we hear about Sayyidina Uthman? We don't. How many times we hear about Sayyidina Ali, who ruled 6 years almost? We don't. That's what I said. When you have a masjid named Ali ibn Abi Talib, they say, is this Shia masjid? Who is Sayyidina Ali for the Shia? Well, Sayyidina Ali is the fourth Khalifa. And when somebody talks about Sayyidina Ali, now he's accused of one of being Shia. Tabarakallah al-Azim. Even though the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, in the Sahih of Imam Muslim, which is hadith mutawatir, narrated by so many people, said, وَالَّذِي فَلَقَ الْحَبَّ وَبَرَاءَ النَّسْمَةِ. By him who created the bean and sent the wind, Ya Ali, O Ali, لا يحبك إلا مؤمن ولا يبغضك إلا منافق. Only he who loves you is mu'min. It's a son of iman. And he who dislikes you is munafiq. Therefore, this is hadith sahih. And therefore, Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, سيد التابعين. In his time, he used to say this. In the time after Sayyidina Ali was murdered in Medina, we used to go and know the munafiqeen by their dislike to Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib. So, we are manifesting, dear brothers, that the ummah, the jumhur ummah, can sense that the best of the four are the best of the ummah after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali. And the majority of the ummah consensed also that they are better according to their khilafah. Is this again lighting the fire again? We love them all equally. And we feel that we get closer to Allah by loving Sayyidina Abu Bakr, and loving Sayyidina Umar, and loving Sayyidina Uthman, and loving Sayyidina Ali. And those who don't love them and don't like them, wallahi, all of them, all four of them, wallahi, they have nifaq in their heart. Ey wallah. Because those people are those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. What can you do? Allah is pleased with them. Allah said, I am pleased with them. Not only that, they are pleased with me. We don't favor them of any other prophets, but we favor them over everybody else. We love them consequently, like they came. We don't, when we talk about Sayyidina Uthman and we talk about Sayyidina Ali, we don't mean we favor them over anybody else. We favor them in sequence. We follow the book of Allah and the authentic sunnah of Rasulullah. And those who want to have bad judgments and all these evil thinking about people, they should rest. Take it easy. Think about how can we better ourselves. How can we be better humans? Wallahi, sometimes we have to think about how we be better humans. Not even Muslims, better humans. We are Muslims, but sometimes even this humanity, we're losing that touch with it.
Takbir! Allahu Akbar!
This is Islam. How can we give other people, non-Muslims, how can we give them love or mercy at least? Mercy, let's say, so we don't say love, of course. Mercy. And we don't have mercy on each other. How? They look at us and they say, look at them.
He's called this, this called this, this is this, this is this. And everybody fights and puts all their power, all their money to fight the other. Nullify the other. And they look at us and say, look at them. Are these people, can these people give us any mercy? Any prosperity, any understanding, anything? Not really. Not really. We are the reason Islam is being misjudged, dear brothers and sisters. We, me and everybody else. We are the reason. Islam is high. But what we want to do, we want to bring Islam down to our level. We don't want to rise to the level of Islam. Islam is the deen of Allah. And the deen of Allah can never be humiliated. But we Muslims, if we don't follow the deen of Allah, we will be humiliated. And we are. And look at the last 400 years until now. What happened to Muslims?